Hey guys, and welcome to the first video of this channel. I'll introduce myself. My name is George Zakaria, and I'm a third year medical student at Government Medical College, Thiruvananthapuram. So, hats off to all those students out there who have qualified in the NEET exams and are ready to enter into something they dreamed for many years, something they sacrificed many years for, the course of MBBS and the opportunity to wear a stethoscope. And I thought this time, the first thing maybe what you people would be looking for is where to take your MBBS degree. For people who have qualified in the top level exams like the AIIMS, the national institutes like AIIMS or JIPMA, they might not have any other choice. They will be definitely going for the institute such as AIIMS or JIPMA, because it's an institute of national importance. You have a very low fees there, and it's something like of a pride which you could tell you an AIIMS alumni. But for a vast majority of students who have qualified NEET and are looking at the state government or any other private colleges, maybe this video would be helpful. And even definitely those who are planning to go on AIIMS or JIPMA, I guess it would be helpful. So one thing would be definitely what I would just like to say is, check your ranks and see what sort of colleges or what are the last ranks of the colleges you're aiming for, and check which all colleges are possible for your rank. So think logically and think properly. We should not aim so high, and with our rank maybe we might not be able to get such a college, and then when getting the result you might be disappointed, or maybe if you didn't give the college during a counseling you might not receive a college at all. So definitely the first thing is to check previous year last ranks and how the allotment process goes, and you find this will be the college I might be getting this time. So choose your options, go through all the colleges possible which you could get with your rank, and choose the best. How to choose the best is what I'll be talking about mainly. Choosing the best in terms, one is the hospital as such, how many patients come. I study in one of the top government colleges in India, and especially the one of the premier colleges in Kerala too. So we have a lot of patients, we have a lot of influx of patients, and as a UG student you have a lot of opportunities to do stuff, to do procedures. But I have friends who study in some private colleges or some other colleges where there are not influx of patients, and they don't actually get to do a lot of stuff. They don't see a lot of patients, and they feel that they have a bit of less experience, so they feel they are somewhere behind. So always to avoid that option, best always do a research, talk to students of that college which you're aiming for, and see what's the situation over there, and choose accordingly. You should study in an awesome college, because let me say, this is one of your most crucial, this MBBS years, and it's actually a college life. You will get a college life in MBBS. You won't get a college life during your MD, MS, DM, MCH periods. It will be like pure work. If you want college life, it's only in MBBS. And that's the second thing what you have to look for, your college life. How is the life at your college? I know there are some colleges which are particularly dry. It's only academics, okay? They don't have much of student activities or student facilities, etc. You might feel very bored, or you might feel maybe sometimes much stressed over there. While for example my college, the activities are numerous, and you might consider maybe you're an arts college or some a college from another stream where the students are much more free. We have activities in most of the weeks, we have at least one or two activities, and we have a lot of we have also have DJ nights, we have a lot of festivals, celebrations. The life is superb, and that's very important. Actually a lot of clubs, for example I'm interested in quizzing, so there's a quizzing club where I could go for. There are a lot of other colleges in my city where I could go for quizzing competitions. If you're a sports fanatic, you need to have lots of ground, sporting time, free periods, free places, not periods, okay? There's no MBBS, there's no periods for PT. What I mean is you get time enough to play sports, so that's important. So the first what you talked about is choosing the good hospital, a place where there's a lot of influx of patients. Second is a place where there's a good college life. Third is your proximity to home and stuff like that. you get vacations, you get vacations, it's not 2 month vacations, you have only second Saturdays and Sundays in my college, and after first year you get about one and a half months vacation before the results come, then your vacations are all your study leaves. So, you know, try to maybe, you know, my personal bias is always I would like to study in a college where, you know, I could go home, you know, suppose I wish to, maybe the journey is less than a day or journey of 7 to 8 hours, you know, I could at least go home. Like I know friends, I have friends, you know, who are in the north, so they are not able to go home during the small vacations, like 2-3 days vacation, because the travel itself takes a lot of time. So so personally what I feel is definitely, you know, try to maybe, it depends on you. Suppose if you want to stay away, you don't feel homesick and stuff like that, your wish, your wish. The next thing is, check the academics, the prestige of the college, how old the college is, you know, the facilities, the infrastructure. Those are also very important. And talk to doctors, you know, talk to doctors and ask them how is that college. You might find some alumni, you know, the doctors who study from that college who are working, maybe some family doctors, you know, ask them, you know, Dr. G, you know, how is studying there, what's the life there. Ask to current students and get to know the truth. Don't believe what is given on websites, you know, stuff like that, or video, you know, purely go personal and ask people and know what's the actual life over there, because you should not be misled. Because this 5 years or 5 years, this 5.5 years is like crucial moments, and you're going to spend the majority, a chunk of your time, the major chunk of this 5.5 years in that college, in that hostel or in that surroundings. You don't want it to be, you know, gone or very bad and stuff like that. So definitely do a very good research before choosing your college. And I'm sure, you know, you people will get into awesome colleges with awesome friends, awesome faculty, awesome college life, you know, an awesome hospital. That's an important thing. The hospital part is the most important thing, okay? The other things are also important. But, you know, a doctor, the main thing is you get more experience. Because let me say, if you study in a well-equipped hospital with enough influx of patients and you have a lot of experience, you know, treating patients, doing procedures, diagnosing and stuff like that, you'll have confidence to practice after you finish MBBS. After you finish this 5.5 years, you would have, you know, confidence to practice as a practitioner. I know many people, those, you know, maybe in their colleges, they didn't have enough of such influx of patients. Their you know, knowledge is limited to the theory textbooks. They themselves still, they don't have much of clinical experience. They still, after passing out, even after 3-4 years, they haven't started practicing. Okay, they are preparing for PG. They are trying to make up for their lost clinical experience by doing a good PG in a good hospital with a lot of influx of patients. So, you know, they are, you know, a lot of years are wasted, right? Otherwise, if you had clinical practice, you could simultaneously work and maybe, you know, do your PG if you don't clear it in your first or second attempt. So, my dear friends, my dear young doctors, budding doctors, you are now naive teenagers and you're going to enter into colleges and you're going to be metamorphosed to, you know, elite clinicians in 5.5 years. I'm sure you'll all do well. You know, you people will be in prayers, and also do keep in touch, ask doubts and stuff like that. More videos to come, and I hope you support this small channel. Thank you. Good day.